टोटली सेकंड ईयर स्कूल इज अ सॉलिड स्टेट सॉल्यूशंस इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री एंड केमिकल काइनेटिक्स and surface chemistry, metallurgy, and groups totally 15, 16, 17, and 18. And chemistry nevertheless, and four units of organic chemistry. That means have organic series and organic compounds containing CH4. Last one is organic compounds containing nitrogen. Okay. Today we will discuss about Chalk-Hayes solutions. Solutions. What is important thing is here. Solutions means. Solutions means a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Solutions means homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. That is called true solution. That is called true solution. Here, solution means homogeneous mixture, but not heterogeneous mixture. This is a homogeneous mixture. And solution contains two or more substances. Two or more substances. Here, if solution contains solution contains two components. The type of solutions are called binary solutions. Solution contains two components. These are called binary solutions. First of all, solution contains three components. That is ternary solutions. First of all, solution contains four components. That is quaternary solutions. Solution contains four or more substances. Already answered. Here, solution contains two components. That type of solutions are called binary solutions. First of all, solution contains three components. That type of solutions are called ternary solutions. Here, four components. First of all, four components present in the solution. That type of solutions are quaternary solutions. Quaternary solutions. But in this chapter. But in this chapter, we will discuss about only binary solutions. Here, binary solution means solution contains two components. Only two components. Binary solution means solution contains only two components. They are solute and solvent. In a binary solution, only two components are present. These are solute and solvent. Here, solute means the component which is present in lesser quantity in a solution. The component which is present in lesser quantity. Okay, now here okay na. Solution contains two components. That's why solutions are called binary solutions. Solution contains three components. That's why solutions are called ternary solutions. Here, solution contains four components. That's why solutions are called quaternary solutions. Okay, next one. Here, but in the chapter, we will discuss about only binary solutions. Binary solution means it contains only two components. Solute and solvent. Here, solute means the component which is present in lesser quantity in a solution. The component which is present in larger quantity, that is called solvent. Solute means this is lesser quantity. Solvent means larger quantity present in solution. Okay. The word solute is taken from Latin word solutus. Solutus, which means dissolve. The word solute is taken from Latin word solutus, which means dissolve. The word solvent, it is taken from Greek word. That is salo, which means fear. Salt in water and sugar in water. How can I give the salt solution? Nothing but salt in water. You take your beaker, which is having some amount of water. Now, you add in some amount of salt in your water. Then some solution is formed. First of all, you take in one beaker which is having some amount of water into this water. Some amount of sodium chloride and salt is added to this water. Then salt solution is formed. How many components present in the solution? Only two components. That means one is sodium chloride and salt, another one is water. In between sodium chloride and water, which one is lesser quantity, which one is larger quantity? In salt solution, salt is lesser quantity, water is larger quantity. So in salt solution, salt is a solute, and water is a solvent. In a salt solution, salt is solute, water is a solvent. Another example, sugar in water. Okay, here, how can we create a solution? As I can be from people, adding some amount of water, and then, and then super solution is formed. Super solution is formed. In this super solution, sugar and water content are present. In this sugar and water, sugar is lesser quantity, water is larger quantity. That's why this is lesser quantity, this is larger quantity. So here this is solute, this is solvent. That means in sugar solution, sugar is solute and water is solvent. Water is solvent. Okay. Let us say one more example for explaining the solutions here. Solution is 80% water and 20% alcohol. Simple introduction for the solutions here. Solutions means homogeneous mixture of two or more substances here. Solutions contains two components. That type of solutions are called binary solutions. Or suppose solutions contains three components. That type of solutions are called ternary solutions. Or suppose solution contains four components. That is quaternary solutions. Quaternary solutions. Here in the chapter we will discuss about only binary solutions. Binary solution means a solution contains only two components. That type of solutions are called binary solutions. These two components are, one is solute, another is solvent. Solute means the component which is present in lesser quantity, that is solute. The component which is present in larger quantity, that is solvent. Okay, we see here three examples for explanation of solutions: salt solution, sugar solution, and mixture of 80% water and 20% alcohol. It is 80% water and 20% alcohol. It is here. 20% means lesser quantity, this is larger quantity. So that's why 20% alcohol is a solute, 80% water is a solvent in this type of solutions. Okay, next one is types of solutions. Types of solutions. Now, based on the physical state of solutions, solutions are classified into three categories. Gaseous solutions and liquid solutions and solid solutions. Based on the physical state of the solution. Solutions are classified into three types. There are gaseous solutions, liquid solutions, and solid solutions. It is based on solutions. In gaseous solutions, solvent is a gas. If solution contains here, solvent is a gas, that type of solutions are called gaseous solutions. If solvent is a liquid, that type of solutions are called liquid solutions. And solvent is a solid, that type of solutions are called solid solution. That means in gaseous solution, solvent is a gas. Here in liquid solution, solvent is a liquid. In solid solution, solvent is a solid. Okay, these three types of solutions again classified into three types. First one is
gaseous solution is classified into three types. That means here first type is gas in gas type. Gas in gas type. Gas in gas type and liquid in gas, solid in gas. Gas in gas, liquid in gas, solid in gas. Another one is liquid solution. Liquid solutions also classified into three types. Liquid solutions also. Liquid solutions also classified into three types. They are gas in liquid and liquid in liquid and solid in liquid. Solid in liquid. Liquid solutions are classified into three types. They are gas in liquid, liquid in liquid, solid in liquid. Another type is solid solution. Another type is solid solutions. It is also classified into three types. Here, gas in solid, liquid in solid, solid in solid, solid in solid, gas in solid, liquid in solid, solid in solid. Here, you observe this here, solvent is same, gas, in gaseous solutions. Here, solvent is same, liquid, in liquid solution. Here, solid, in this solid solutions. Now, example for this, example. Gas in gas, example for gas in gas. A mixture of oxygen and nitrogen gas. Oxygen and nitrogen gas. Here, the example for gas in gas. In this type of solution, solute is a gas, solvent also gas. Solute is a gas, solvent also gas. Example for this mixture, a mixture of oxygen and nitrogen gas. Here, both oxygen and nitrogen, both are gases. So next one, liquid in gas. Chloroform mixed with nitrogen gas. Chloroform mixed with nitrogen gas. Here, liquid in gas type of solution. Example is chloroform mixed with nitrogen gas. Here, chloroform is liquid, nitrogen gas is gas. Chloroform is in liquid state, nitrogen gas is in gaseous state. Another one is solid in gas. Solid in gas. Camphor in nitrogen gas. Camphor in nitrogen gas. Here camphor is solid state, nitrogen gas is gaseous state. Here these types of gas in gas, liquid in gas, solid in gas. Example for these three types of solution. The next one is liquid solution. Here gas in liquid, liquid in liquid, solid in liquid. Gas in liquids. In this type of gas in liquid solution, example for this type of solution here, oxygen dissolved in water. Oxygen dissolved in water. Oxygen is a gas, water is a liquid. Another example is CO2 dissolved in your water. That means soda water. Soda water means carbon dioxide dissolved in a water, that is soda water. So oxygen is a gas, water is a liquid. Next one is liquid in liquid. Example for liquid in liquid solution, ethanol dissolved in water. Ethanol dissolved in water. Here ethanol and water both are in liquid state. Ethanol is a liquid, water is a liquid. Another one is solid in liquid. Here, so many examples for this. Glucose dissolved in water. Here, glucose is a solid, water is a liquid. Glucose is a solid, water is a liquid. Another example here, gas in solid type. Gas in solid. Occlusion. Occlusion of hydrogen gas on palladium metal. Occlusion of hydrogen gas on palladium metal. Here, hydrogen is a gas, palladium metal is a solid. Next one is liquid in solid. Liquid in solid. Amalgam. Amalgam of mercury with sodium metal. Amalgam of mercury with sodium metal. Here, mercury is in liquid state, sodium metal is in solid state. Next, last one is solid in solid. Solid in solid. Copper, copper dissolved in gold. Copper dissolved in gold. That means here you take already when on that you take 24 carats gold. 24 carats gold. This is a pure one. This is a pure one. To this 24 carats gold, you add in copper as a impurity. It gives 22 carats gold. 22 carats gold. So this is larger quantity. This is smaller quantity. This is larger quantity. This is smaller quantity. So it is a solvent, it is a solute. Both these solute and solvent mixing to each other, then solid solution is formed. Solid solution is formed. This is types of solution, gaseous solution, liquid solution, solid solution. In this gaseous solution, it is a classified into again three types, gas in gas, liquid in gas, solid in gas. Example for gas in gas, mixture of oxygen and nitrogen gas. Here, liquid in gas, chloroform mixed with nitrogen gas. Another example is, already you see in winter season, early morning, moisture in air, water droplet present in air, moisture in air. That is also example for liquid in gas, next one solid in gas, camphor in nitrogen gas. Here, camphor is solid, nitrogen is gas. Another one is liquid solution, liquid solution. Here, gas in liquid, liquid in liquid, solid in liquid. In gas and liquid, O2 dissolved in water, that means oxygen dissolved in water. Here oxygen is a gas, water is a liquid. Another example, CO2 dissolved in water, that means soda water. CO2, carbon dioxide. CO2 is a gas and water is a liquid. Another type is liquid in liquid. Ethanol dissolved in water, ethanol is a liquid, water is a liquid. Another one is solid in liquid, glucose dissolved in water. Here, glucose is a solid, water is a liquid. Another one is solid solution, solid solution. Here, gas in solid, occlusion of hydrogen gas on palladium metal. Here, hydrogen is a gas, palladium is a solid, palladium metal is a solid. Here, liquid in solid, amalgam of mercury with a sodium metal. In this example, mercury is a liquid and sodium metal is a solid. And the last one is solid in solid. Copper dissolved in gold. Both are metals. Copper dissolved in gold. Both are solid. Copper is a solid. Gold is a solid. Okay. Next classification is based on the nature of solvent. Based on the nature of solvent, here, if solvent is water, that type of solutions are called aqueous solution. Aqueous solution. In aqueous solution, solvent is water. Solvent is water. Solvent is water. In non-aqueous solution, non-aqueous solution. In non-aqueous solution, solvent is other than water. Solvent is other than water. That means carbon tetrachloride, carbon disulfide, and benzene, and acetic acid, liquid ammonia, liquid sulfur dioxide, These are all solvents using in non-aqueous solutions. For suppose, if solvent is alcohol, this type of solutions are called alcoholic solutions. If solvent is alcohol, this type of solutions are called alcoholic solutions. If solvent is ether, this type of solutions are called ethereal, ethereal solutions. Okay, next one is, the solvent is liquid ammonia. This type of solutions are called ammonical. Yeah. In aqueous solution, solvent is water. In non-aqueous solution, solvent is other than water. That means carbon tetrachloride, carbon disulfide, and benzene, and liquid sulfur dioxide, liquid ammonia, and acetic acid. These are all used as a solvent in non-aqueous solution. And if alcohol, solvent is alcohol, this type of solutions are called alcoholic solutions. If solvent is ether, this type of solutions are called ethereal solutions. If solvent is liquid ammonia, this type of solutions are called ammonical solutions. Okay, generally, the physical state of the solution will be decided by the solvent, not solute. That means solvent is a decider the physical state of the solution. For example, here, solvent is a gas. Solution is in gaseous. That means here, this type of solutions are called gaseous solutions. Solvent is a liquid. That type of solutions are called liquid solutions. For suppose, solvent is a solid. That type of solutions are called solid solutions. So, physical state of the solution will be decided by the solvent only, but not solute. Okay, next one. Based on the amount of solute present in the solution, these are classified into three types. They are dilute solutions and concentrated solutions. Dilute solutions and concentrated solutions. Dilute solutions mean the solution which contains very small amount of solute. That is called dilute solutions. Here, concentrated solutions mean very larger amount of solute. That is called concentrated solutions. Dilute solutions means the solutions which contain very small amount of solute. Okay. The solutions contain very large amount of solute, that is called concentrated solution. For example, let us say an example here, you take one beaker which is having some amount of water. In this beaker, we adding the 5 grams of salt. 5 grams of salt is adding to the this water. You take another beaker, same amount of water here. Here, 20 grams of salt is adding to this water. Both are salt solutions. This is salt solution, this is also salt solution. But in case here, in this solution, solute nothing but salt, only 5 grams. In this case, 20 grams. Here, 5 grams of solute present only, here 20 grams of salt, 20 grams of salt. So that's why this is lesser quantity, this is larger quantity. This is a smaller amount of solute present in the solution, larger amount of solute present in the solution. So this is concentrated compared to that of this type of solution. That means this solution. This is concentrated solution compared to that of this solution. This is diluted solution compared to that of this solution. Why? Because here smaller amount of solute present in this salt solution, here larger amount of solute present in the solution. That is difference between dilute and concentrated solution. Okay, overall the lesser amount of the solution which contains lesser amount of solute, that is called dilute solution. The solution which contains larger amount of solute or higher amount of solute, that is called concentrated solutions. Okay, if you adding more amount of water to the concentrated solutions, and then this is also diluted. That means here dilute solution and concentrated solutions. Dilute solutions means a solution which contains very small amount of solute, that is called dilute solution. Here a solution contains very higher amount or larger amount of solute but not solvent is there. But what is the difference here? Solute content. Here lesser amount of solute, here larger amount of solute. So lesser amount of solute means dilute solution, larger amount of solute is concentrated solution. Okay, concentration means the amount of solute present in unit volume of the solution. The amount of solute present in unit volume of the solution, that is called concentration. Okay, now I am saying that here expressing concentration methods, they are mass percentage, volume percentage, mass by volume percentage. First one is mass percentage, second one is mass by volume percentage. Next, molality, seventh one, normality, and mole fraction, formality also, mass percentage, volume percentage, mass by volume percentage, ppm, parts per million, and molality, normality, mole fraction. Okay, next one. First one is mass percentage. Mass percentage means the mass of the solute present in the 100 grams of solution. The mass of the solute present in 100 grams of the solution, that is called mass percentage. Mass of the solute present in 100 grams of solution, that is called mass percentage. Mass percentage means mass of the solute present in 100 grams of solution, that is called mass percentage. Here mass percentage means that is equal to mass of solute by total mass of solution into 100. That is mass percentage. Mass percentage is equal to mass of solute by total mass of solution into 100. That is small w grams of solute is adding to the capital W grams of solvent. Then here W by W percentage is equal to small w by small w plus capital W into 100. Here small w is equal to mass of solute. Capital W is equal to mass of solvent. Small w plus capital W is equal to total mass of solution. Here W, small w is equal to mass of solute, capital W is equal to mass of solvent. Here small w plus capital W, that is mass of solution. Already you know that solution is equal to solute plus solvent. Here solute means small w, solvent means capital W. Small w plus capital W is a mass of solution. Okay, for example 10 grams of glucose is dissolved in 90 grams of water. It gives 100 grams of solution. 10 grams of glucose is mixed with 90 grams of water. It gives 100 grams of solution. Okay, this type of solution, this is 10 grams, this is 90 grams. So this is lesser quantity, this is larger quantity. This is 10 grams is a lesser quantity, 90 grams is a larger quantity. So that's why in this type of solution, this is a solute, this is a solvent. This is a solute, this is a solvent. Okay, here small w means mass of solute, that means 10 grams. So W by W percentage is equal to 10 by small w plus capital W, that means mass of solution. Mass of solution means 10 plus 90, that is equal to 100 grams. So 10 by 100 into 100. W by W percentage is equal to 10 by 100 into 100. Here 100 to 100 cancel. Here 10% glucose by mass. 10% glucose by mass. Here 10% glucose by mass means that 10 grams of glucose dissolved in 90 grams of water. 10% glucose by mass or glucose solution means that 10 grams of glucose is dissolved in 90 grams of water. That is mass percentage. It has no units. Generally, mass percentage is used in industrial chemical applications. This is mass percentage. Mass percentage means the mass of the solute present in 100 grams of solution, that is called mass percentage. Here mass percentage is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution, in total mass of solution into 100. Mass percentage is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. Here W by W percentage, that is equal to small w by small w plus capital W into 100. Here small w is equal to mass of solute, capital W is equal to mass of solvent, and small w plus capital W, that is equal to mass of solution. Let us say one example here. 10 grams of glucose is adding to the 90 grams of water, then resulting solution is 100 grams of solution is formed. Here 10 grams of glucose is a lesser quantity, 90 grams of water is a larger quantity. This is a solute. This is solvent. In this solution, weight of solute means 10 grams. Weight of solvent means 90 grams. Total weight, nothing but total mass of the solution is 100 grams. Okay, these values are substituting this formula W by W percentage 10 by 100 into 100. That is equal 10% glucose by mass. That means 10% glucose solution. 10% glucose solution means 10 grams of glucose dissolved in 100 grams of solution. It has no units. That means mass percentage has no units. And it is commonly used in industrial chemical application. Industrial chemical application. Another one is mass or volume percentage. Volume percentage. Mass percentage means the mass of solute present in 100 grams of solution. Here volume percentage means the volume of solute present in 100 ml of solution. Volume of solute present in or dissolved in 100 ml of solution. Here volume. The volume of solute present in 100 ml of solution. That is called volume percentage. That means volume percentage is equal to volume of solute by total volume of solution into 100. That means V by V percentage is equal to small v by small v plus capital V into 100. Here, small v. V means volume of the solute. Capital V means volume of solvent. Small v plus capital V, that is equal to total volume of the solution. Total volume of the solution. Okay, let us say one example here. 10 ml of ethanol mixed with 10 ml of ethanol mixed with 90 ml of water resulting 100 ml of solution. 100 ml of solution. 10 ml of ethanol mixed with 90 ml of water, it gives 100 ml of solution. In this V by V percentage is equal to, here this is smaller or lesser quantity. 10 ml of ethanol is a lesser quantity. 90 ml of water is a larger quantity. So this is solute, this is solvent, this is solution. That means volume of solute means 10 ml. Volume of solution, that means 100 into 100. Here is also 10%. 10% ethanol solution. Here, 10% ethanol solution means 10 ml of ethanol is dissolved in 100 ml of solution. 100 ml of solution. Okay. It has not any units and it depends on temperature. This is volume percentage. Volume percentage means volume of solute present in 100 ml of solution, that is called volume percentage. Volume percentage is equal to volume of solute by total volume of solution. Volume of solute by total volume of solution into 100. Let us say example here, 10 ml of ethanol is dissolved in 90 ml of water, it gives 100 ml of solution. In this solution, 10 ml of ethanol is a solute, 90 ml of water is a solvent. So V by V percentage, volume of solute, nothing but 10 ml, by total volume of solution is 100 ml. 10 by 100 into 100, that is equal to 10% ethanol solution. 10% ethanol solution means 10 ml of ethanol is present in 100 ml of solution. Okay, next concentration method is mass percentage means mass of solute present in 100 grams of solution. Volume percentage means volume of solute present in 100 ml of solution. Another one is mass by volume percentage. Mass by volume percentage. Here, mass by volume percentage means mass of solute present in mass of solute present in 100 ml of solution. That is mass by volume percentage. Mass of solute present in 100 ml of solution. Here, mass by volume percentage is equal to mass of solute by volume, volume of solution into 100. Generally, mass volume percentage is used in medicine. It is used in medicine and pharmacy. Medicine and pharmacy. Okay, mass by volume percentage means mass of solute present in 100 ml of solution. Here, mass by volume percentage is equal to mass of solute by volume of solution into 100. It is used in generally medicine and pharmacy. Medicine and pharmacy. Okay, next one, ppm. Parts per million. Parts per million. Parts per million. PPM means, on PPM is equal to number of parts of one component by total number of parts of all components present in solution. Number of parts of one component by total number of parts of all components in solution into 10 power 6. This ppm, when a solute is very trace quantities, it is convenient to express the concentration of solution by parts per million. Very trace quantity, that means very very small amount of solute when present in solution, that type of solution concentration is expressed by ppm, parts per million. Generally, atmospheric pollution in cities, it is expressed by the ppm. That means 10 ppm of solute or sulfur dioxide, 10 ppm of sulfur dioxide present in a 10 ppm of SO2 in air. That means here, ml of sulfur dioxide present in 10 power 6 ml of air. 10 ml of SO2 is present in 10 power 6 ml of air. That is ppm, parts per million. Sometimes it is also expressed in microgram per ml. Sometimes it is also expressed as microgram per ml. This is ppm. Here, mass by volume percentage means mass of the solute present in 100 ml of solution. That is called mass by volume percentage. Mass by volume percentage, that is equal to mass of solute by volume of solution into 100. And it is used in medicine and pharmacy. Medicine and pharmacy. Ppm means parts per million. PPM means parts per million. Generally, this PPM Then a solute is very phase quantity, that means very very small amount present in a solution, it is convenient to express the concentration of solution. Here ppm equal to number of parts of one component by total number of parts of all components in solution into 10 power 6. That means the amount of solute present in 10 power 6 ml of solution. The amount of solute present in 10 power 6 ml of solution, that is called parts per million, ppm. Atmospheric pollution in cities expressed in ppm, 10 ppm of SO2, that means here 10 ml of SO2 present in 10 power 6 ml of air, that is 10 ppm of SO2. Sometimes here we need microgram per ml.
Again, they are 2 equal 0.
Again, they are what?
I think
they are continuing.
I think.